Welcome to One Take JoJo Summaries. I'm going to be talking about the parts of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure that we're not covering, and I'm going to try to do it in one take. I don't want to write a script, nor do I want to put a super shit ton of effort into this, but I do want to cover this as well as I can. And today we're going to be talking about Phantom Blood, the first part of the series that covers the story of Jonathan Joestar. By the way, when I said not put a ton of effort, I mean not make a script. There's going to be a ton of silly pictures with this video, probably. And I don't know. I would rather you have that than me make a script. Story begins in, like, 1886, I think. It's Victorian era England, I know that. Also, I forgot to mention that at the start of the series, there's this, like, Aztec ritual where this woman is sacrificed for the mask that this big buff Aztec guy makes. And they didn't cover this in the anime, probably because it required a woman being stabbed. Anyways, back to the point. Dio Brando lives in the gutters of England, and his life sucks, and his dad throws whiskey at him. And Jonathan lives in luxury, eats nice steak, and his dad feeds him wine. At some point, Dio's dad dies, and he goes off to live with the Joestars, because he was, Oh yeah, that's right. I forgot to mention this. His dad found Jonathan's dad with the fucking carriage over the side of a cliff or something. I don't remember. His driver was impaled. His wife was dead, and baby Jonathan was there. And Dario was actually trying to steal his teeth or something. But George? Yes, George. George thought he was trying to actually help him. And then, yeah. Anyways, Dio lives with the Joestars now. He's a huge asshole and knees Jonathan's dog in the face after meeting him right away. Then he decides to pull on Jonathan's ear and says he's number one.
Listen, I may be a guest within your house, but I am not to be trifled with. In all things that I do, I am number one.
And he proceeds to make Jonathan's life a living hell for no reason other than he's a complete douchebag. But Jonathan, at some point, finds a way to cope with it and deal with it, and then more stuff happens.
From the first day he showed up, he's been trying to destroy me! Damn you, Dio Brando! Dio! 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 Dio!
So I forgot to mention this character, because I was rambling. But near the start, before all of this happens, Jonathan saves a little girl from being bullied by two British youths, one of them incredibly British.
Stop, please, yeah, just yeah.
Oh, let me guess, Serena. Your daddy bought you this doll, didn't he? It's fancy. Being a quack must pay him real nice. I know. What do you say we peel off this fancy-looking dress, huh? And see if they made her with all the real girl bits underneath.
He gets his ass kicked by these kids after they are bullying her. And because he is one of the, he's part of the Joestar family, who are the higher class and they are lower class, and they don't like that he has money. So anyways, she's grateful for that, and she gives him grapes later, and then they start dating after that. And Jonathan's having a pretty good time, because someone likes him and he likes her, and Dio can't possibly ruin this for him, except he does.
He did it!
Give her the what for? The trouble I'd get into if I were as brave as Dio! He just does what he wants, devil may care!
Tell me, have you and JoJo kissed yet? I'll take that as a no. You thought your first kiss would be JoJo, but it was I, Dio!
Jonathan proceeds to beat the piss out of him afterwards, and then Johnny Young Bosch happens, and then, George? Yes, George. Sends them both to their room. Dio sets Jonathan's dog on fire because he's a huge baby, and then several tons of years, I think 10 years, no, it's like 7. 7 years pass, and now they're big and buff, and like they're out of the Fist of the North Star. Everyone's happy except Dio's poisoning George. Jonathan goes to Ogre Street and meets the best character ever. His name is Speedwagon. He has a bowler hat that has blades on it. Jonathan kicks him really hard, and then Speedwagon's like, oh no, you're cool actually, you're a super nice guy because you kicked me really hard, but you didn't kill me.
I came here for the sake of my father. You have a family. People who expect you to return from this dark business. It is not my place to cause them grief.
He means it, don't he? How this fella survived so long? Wait. He spared my mate's lives just like he did mine. I like the cut of his jib. Sure, he's naive, but he's a gentleman through and through, this one.
Then he takes him to meet the Chinaman that Dio bought the poison from, and then they go and find out that Dio has been experimenting with the mask that was from the Aztec people, because they have that for some reason. And the mask turns you into vampires. They figured this out while they were beating the shit out of each other as kids, and Dio's blood fell onto the mask. Accidentally, of course. Dio would never drop blood wastefully. So Dio's super salty that they figured out that he was trying to kill George and take the inheritance for himself. And he turns himself into a vampire, because that's what you do in this scenario, of course. There's some sob story in between all of this about a police officer and how he let Dio's father go away or some shit. Who cares? George is dead. I almost called him Jonathan. George is dead. Jonathan carries his spirit within him, which is metaphor that he's carrying it on as well, of course. Jonathan and Dio proceed to fight. The house starts to burn down. And then Jonathan impales Dio on the statue in the middle of the foyer.
Kicked! And that put them right in line with...
What the?!
The statue of the Joestar family's guardian angel.
How could a worm like you...
At some point, Dio yells out, useless little odd. Viz decided to translate this as Muda, as in not translated at all. Whatever. But Joseph not Joseph, he comes in the next part. Jonathan escapes the fire, and Speedwagon takes him to a clinic, and who's there but Arena as an adult now? And Jonathan and Arena decide to rekindle their lost relationship while Speedwagon is creeping on them like a huge creep. But then he skedaddles, and the next day, Arena and Jonathan are walking, and there's this dude in a really weird hat following them, and it turns out the dude's Italian, and he knows the Ripple. I'm not gonna call it Haman, even though that's what the actual name is at this point, but it's because Ripple sounds like a thing.
Ah, Signore Joestar. And the lass at your side is Signorina Pendleton.
Who are you?
You survived against the mask. Not many men can claim that.
JoJo!
That's right. Let the shock of that impact push all the air from your body.
JoJo! Why? He was already hurt, you cad!
It's true, I knocked the air out of him, but he'll thank me for it.
My arm! What is this? My broken bones feel like they're mending!
Baron Zeppeli, at your service. Courage alone will not be enough to beat the mask.
So, the man is named Will A. Zeppeli. The A stands for Antonio. And he's gonna teach Jonathan how to use the Ripple because Dio is actually alive. And he has to fight the vampires, and the Ripple will let you channel the energy of the sun through your breathing, because it's an Eastern martial art style kind of thing. Meditation. There, Tom Petty is involved somehow. Anyways, they train, and train, and train. And then Speedwagon says, we found where Dio might probably be. Let's go. At some point, Dio... Well, no. They go on the carriage, and... they go on the carriage, and then... they get into like a tunnel, and then Jack the Ripper is there as a vampire, having pulled a horse's head off. Dio apparently recruited Jack the Ripper at some point for reasons, and then Jonathan kills him, and then Zeppeli throws wine at him. So they make it out of that situation, and then there's this kid who steals their stuff. I think he's named Poco. Yeah, he's Poco. There's another character later called Poco Loco, and I get them confused a lot because they have the same first half of a name. And then it turns out he was being mind-controlled, and then as soon as they save him, after Jonathan throws him off the side of a cliff, vampires and zombies show up. Dio's there, he uses ice powers now, because he learned how to do that. And he freezes Zeppeli's arm after Zeppeli says some English at him, which is Italian in the dub, which was a nice little localization thing. Good job, WB. I think Bangzoom handled that, I don't know.
Hey, Bambino! It's easy to be cocky when you're up there out of harm's way! Come and fight!
You dare to address me thus, insect? I, the pinnacle of creation. To mere humans, I am like unto a god! So why would I cavort down in the filth with you?
He almost knocked me off my feet with a blast of pure hate! Already this Dio has the soul of a tyrant!
All of the scars from my battle with JoJo have healed. All save this one. Come, charlatan! Relinquish your blood, that I may erase this imperfection!
Tell me, to undo your injuries, how many innocent lives did you consume?
I don't know. How many loaves of bread have you eaten in your lifetime?
Dio!
So now that Dio has sufficiently fucked up Zeppeli's arm, Jonathan now is being attacked by two knights from the past. Were they serving Queen Elizabeth? I think they hated Queen Elizabeth. I don't remember which queen. This is all historical, by the way. I looked at the record books to tell. And the record books do say there was, in fact, a giant fucking knight and a dude whose hair did things in the past. Anyways, the dude with the hair fights Jonathan underwater, and Jonathan can't breathe, but he finds some air pockets to breathe, and then he uses the ripple to punch him really hard in the face. And then they get on land, and then he tries to use his hair again, and then Jonathan just punches him more in the face with the sun this time, and yelling like Johnny Young Bosch.
How my heart resonates! I'm pulsing with heat and life! My very blood is a symphony within me! Sunlight yellow overdrive!
Oh, there we go, that's it! About time we heard the welcome crackle of Harmon!
After all these punches in the face, Bruford is calmed down. His name's Bruford, by the way. It's Bluford in the dub, which is probably a better name and sounds cooler, but I'm gonna go with Bruford because that's the drummer for Yes, and he's cool. The theme song is Roundabout, by the way. That's also pretty cool. So Bruford dies in peace and starts to... He lights up and there's flowers around him. Then Tarukas, I'm gonna call him Tarukas because that sounds cooler than Tarkus, even though Tarkus is the Emerson, Lake, and Palmer song, which is what Dancing Mad from FF6 ripped off. Tarukas crushes his body, and then he's like, oh, I never liked that dude to begin with. I just want to kill people a lot because I'm huge and strong. And then he starts to attack Zeppeli and Jonathan, and then they all run away on leaves, and then they get to this castle. And somehow Tarukas has worked his way into the castle through some ducts or some shit, and then he pulls Jonathan in there, and apparently the ripple cannot break down the steel door nor the bricks around it. But they get Poco, who's still there, by the way. I don't remember. He's barely there. I don't know. His presence just isn't very notable. But he's there, and he has a flashback to his sister calling him a baby. And Todd Haberkorn is still there for some reason. But he climbs through the area and gets the lever and then opens the door for Zeppeli. And the episode ends on a really cool scene where Roundabout plays into him walking to his death.
Get him, Baron! Go! Give that hulking bastard the what for! Zeppeli?
The day will come when this will be the death of you.
In fine, is tonight the night that I go to my grave? Fate is a fickle mistress, but I cannot deny her.
Zeppeli! Why do you sound so dire?
Oh wait, shouldn't have said that yet. Anyways, we flash back to when Zeppeli was a bit younger and he's on a wire training with Tom Petty to learn how to use the ripple better, and Tom Petty tells him that he's going to die at some point trying to save someone else's life. And then Zeppeli's like, tell me when I'm gonna die, I wanna know. And then Tom Petty says, spoilers, no. Oh wait, you really wanna know? Okay, fine, here. And then Zeppeli walks in to the chamber that Tarukas and Jonathan are fighting in. He tries to help Jonathan, and then he gets, like, bisected, and he's just fucking fucked. And then Zeppeli reaches out to Jonathan as they're both on the ground, like, half-dead, and then he gives him his ripple power through, like, a really cool attack name. I think it's, like, Deep Pass Overdrive? That's a cool name. There's also, like, Sunlight Yellow Overdrive, Aquamarine Blue Overdrive? I don't remember that one. That one was cool, though. I should remember that name. And I think there's, like, Scarlet Red Overdrive, but that's later. That's also a spoiler. Anyway, Zeppeli gives him power, and then he turns into Kenshiro from Fist of the North Star and just, like, wastes Tarukas in, like, 5 seconds flat. It's not even a fight. He just fucking wrecks him. And then they have like a bonfire for Zeppeli as he passes, and it's pretty sad. And then we go to Wind's Night Lot, which is the town they were heading towards with all the vampires in it. And then this, I think Mr. Adams is the name of the random schmuck who tries to kill Poco. And then they kill him in like 5 seconds flat. And then this dude with really dumb hair shows up named Dire. And he does this really stupid attack that never hits anyone, and he will die later because he keeps trying this attack and it's dumb and bad. Don't do it. So anyways, Dire is here with Strazo. People call him Straze. His name's Strazo, though. Please respect the man and his name. It's his life choice. Him and Dire are there. Their names are referenced to Dire Straits. And Tom Petty is there, too, because he's old as shit. And they all go off to fight Dio. And then Dio is terrorizing Poco's sister because he kidnapped her for some reason. And then she, like, said that she doesn't want him at all. And then he leaves her to Doobie. It's Doobie, right? He's the dude with the snakes. Yeah, Doobie. That's his name, Doobie. And then Jonathan shows up and wrecks him in like 5 seconds flat as the other guys are looking on going, yeah, that's pretty cool. Oh, God. They kill Doobie and then they find Dio in like the next room over. And Dio is like super evil as shit posing here. And then Dire tries to fight him and tries to do the dumb attack. Don't do it again. And Dio like freezes him and splits him, and then he's like just a head, and he fires a rose into his eye, and then Dio gets super pissy about that. Did I forget to mention Dio's like evil as shit, by the way? He made a lady eat her baby after turning her into like a zombie. It's pretty hardcore.
Do I comprehend you? Let us clarify what you desire. Voluntarily, you will give yourself to us on the condition that we not touch your child. Is that accurate?
Yes! Only don't hurt my boy!
You move me to tears. Agreed. You shall have your wish. I hereby swear that neither I nor any of my servants will bring harm to your child. That said, you need to be aware of one thing. All my minions, without exception, willingly gave up their souls for me. I truly think it would work out far better if both of you were to join me. There would be no more worries. You would both be part of a new and greater family.
Remember, you promised not to hurt my child! Me for him.
So be it then.
Sweet little child!
As promised, we've not harmed the child. That's something you've taken care of on your own. The irony is lost on you. A pity.
Then Jonathan and Dio start fighting. While this is happening, Strazo is off dealing with Led Zeppelin in the background, and then he drops the chandelier on them, and then they're dead. Rest in peace. Dio and Jonathan keep fighting. Oh my god. Dio and Jonathan are fighting, and at some point Dio freezes him, but Jonathan keeps the sword. I forgot to mention that Bruford gave him the sword that he was using in the fight, and then he put like pluck on it, so it was luck and pluck. Anyways, that's the backstory to the sword.
Sir Jonathan, I leave you this sword given to me by my precious queen and the word engraved upon it. Luck. But first, let me affix my own benediction. Pluck.
Sir Bluefoot!
Go you to your rest. Let no one doubt you have earned it, Bluefoot. Why? Why did I have to strike him down to redeem his soul? He died once before with hate in his heart, but his spirit was still pure. He returned not out of choice, but dragged above by Dio's evil. His evil and the mask's power. I will send them both to hell before the dawn.
And he unfreezes himself, but the sword breaks off inside of Dio after he tries to like split Dio in half, and then Dio puts himself back together and then like grabs Jonathan's jugular vein and starts playing around with it because he's super coy and also a piece of shit. And then Jonathan literally puts his hands on fire and then hits Dio with one last attack after Dio's done talking about monologuing about frog piss and monkeys being better. No, they're worse than men, that's right. I don't know, the dub turned that into a monkey can never beat a lion for some reason. I don't know why, it's whatever.
Oh!
Dio's blocking JoJo!
But no! It's breaking through!
I'm disintegrating! It can't be! The pain, the burning! I can't! My reign was to have lasted forever, for centuries uncounted by man!
You had to be destroyed, Dio.
And then Jonathan fucking destroys him with Scarlet Red Overdrive, and then Dio goes plummeting off the side of the castle into, like, this castle is on a huge-ass cliff, by the way, so Dio's just falling forever into the ground, and then Wang Chung shows up and collects his head because Dio managed to split his head off from his body at the last second because he's fucking hacks. I need water, give me a second. Alright, so everyone thinks Dio is dealt with, and Arena and Jonathan get married, Speedwagon's reading the newspaper, like, that's pretty good. And he's like, oh wait, I'm late, I gotta go see them off. And then everyone, including Speedwagon's cronies, for some reason, who never said a fucking name, never said a fucking thing, are there too. There's some guy named Styx, also named after the rock band Styx, if you couldn't tell, who's a priest. And then he drops, like, his cross at some point downstairs. I don't know what the deal is with him other than to show that the Dio is downstairs and to give us a point of view for that, but, like, whatever, that dude gets fucking killed. And Jonathan and Arena are having fun, and then Jonathan's pressuring her into drinking wine because that's happening. And they're super happy and in love, so of course Dio has to ruin this too, because Jonathan can't have anything nice. Dio is now a head inside of a jar that's being held up by Wang Chung. Wang Chung is the Chinese fellow who gave him the poison and has been working with him pretty much the whole series. Also tried to pull his shit out of the burning wreckage of the mansion. Dio turned him into a vampire zombie minion. And yeah, that's the story behind Wang Chung. So Dio's telling Wang Chung to beware Jonathan. Wang Chung's like, this guy ain't shit, I'll just fucking wreck him, and then he gets wrecked. I forgot to mention Dio shoots laser beam eyes into Jonathan's throat, because he just has that now. He can just do that, for some reason. I think it's like liquid energy coming from his eyes or some bullshit, but it's just laser eyes. He just does it for no reason. And then Jonathan sends him flying into, like, the rotor of the boat, so it stops up and it's gonna explode. Dio tries to take Jonathan's body, because that's the point of this, by the way. He's trying to take Jonathan's body because he super respects him now and is basically in love with him. And then Arena gets into the coffin with a baby that was kind of that's mother died because zombies overran the boat. And she's safe, and then Jonathan dies with Dio in his arms in, like, the saddest moment ever.
JoJo, let me go! Release me! Think of what we two can achieve! You'd like a taste of eternity, would you not? I can heal your wounds. You and Irina can live together forever! JoJo! No. It's too late. He's dead.
The ship explodes, Arian is fine, and she gets out of the coffin in the ocean. At some point she's saved, because otherwise it'd be a pretty sad end of the series if Jonathan and Arian both died. And yeah, that's the end of Phantom Blood. It's pretty good. Please go buy it. It's on sale right now. Your local Barnes & Noble, Amazon, Nooks. I don't know. And the dub is also out as well. The DVD, the subtitles aren't the best, but it's still pretty good. The dub itself is pretty solid quality. I give it an A+ out of A's. And yeah, that's Phantom Blood. I'll probably do a Battle Tendency one pretty soon for the LP thread. Thank you guys for watching. I may or may not LP the Phantom Blood game, don't ask.
It's not good.
Because we'll be there.